Yo ho ho guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco, and today we're going to be covering 5 features that you either knew your whole life or you discovered them just now after 800 years of using 3ds Max. So let's dive deeper into the known unknown depths of 3ds Max. By the way, before we dive into the whole depths thing, I just want to show you something. Well, the scene that I'm going to be using today to show all my examples is this one. And guess what? It's from Evermotion and I got it for free. But even you can get it for free. Check this out. This scene will be added for free to every order placed from 1st December of 2022 to 2nd of January of 2023. So anything you buy of Evermotion, you're gonna get this awesome scene, which is goddamn filled with props. So head over to their website and check out the scene. Our first feature is gonna be an undo history in Max. So check this out. I have this object selected. I'm gonna move it up, move it left, scale it up. I'm gonna add a cylinder, so it's just a different thing. And I'm gonna move that up, add a push modifier, whatever. If you head to your undo button, right click, look, you have all the things that you did. So let's go completely undo this whole thing to the point where I selected this object, hit undo, and you're done. Our second feature is gonna be Modifier Dragging. I don't know how to name this differently, but let me show you what it does. So I have this nice little teapot, which is a little bit inflated because of this push modifier. I also have this UVV map here, but take a look at this. If I long press on my push modifier, I can actually move it to another object. Now when I release it, look, my table now has a push. On the other hand, let's say I have this UVV map here. If I hold control and move it here also, it's gonna be copied here as an instance. Look at this. So both of them now have instances. On the other hand, if you hold shift and let's say move this push, the push will completely be removed from our original teapot and it will just be on our table. Our third feature was discovered by my dear subscriber Carlos, and take a look at this. This is insane. So whenever you need to select one object that's somewhere deep in your scene, let's say one of these packages and one is on the far behind and I just don't see it. Now, so how would you usually select it? You would just, you know, click here and then double click and then double click and then double click until you maybe hit it or maybe not. The worst thing is, if you move your mouse a little bit, this whole order of just going back gets resetted. But take a look at this. If you just spam the button tab, you see what's happening. I'm not doing anything and it's just selecting all the objects. So if I need that package in the back, once I get to it, just click left click and it's gonna be selected. This feature is so awesome. I mean, take a look at it. Look at this. You're just spamming button and it's selecting things in the back. This is amazing. Our fourth feature is called Propagate Materials to Instances. I made 4 instances of these tablecloths. So if I wanna apply a material onto them, look at this. I'm just gonna select this standard material and I'm just gonna click assign material to selection and it's gonna be selected here, right? Cool. But if you go to options and if you click propagate materials to instances, take a look at this. I'm going to apply this material just to that, but it's going to be applied to all instances, even though I just selected one object. So if propagate materials is turned on, when you apply a material to an instance, it's going to apply it to all the other instances. If you have it off, it's just going to apply a material to that one selected object. Our last feature is going to be aligning of loops and edges in unwrap individually. So I have a plane that looks like this. And when I open up my unwrap, it looks like this. If I, let's say, double click on my edge and I just selected it. If I go here and I press ring, I have just selected all of the edges. And now take a look at this. You have these two buttons. One is to align horizontally, one is to align vertically. If you click on the horizontal align, it's just gonna squash everything together. But if you long press, you have this button and it's gonna align each line individually. The same works with the other button. So I'm just gonna double select this. I'm gonna ring this now. And if I long press here, go to the second option, I'm gonna get this. And that's it for today, guys. First of all, whoever celebrates, I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas. If you don't celebrate, I wish you to just be happy and have cool renderings. On the other hand, see you after the new year. Happy New Year, everybody. Evermotion, thank you for sponsoring this video. I don't know what I would do with all these Christmas cheers around me. As you can see, I got like the Christmas tree and lights and everything. Everything was supplied by Evermotion. Thank you guys so much. Love you all. Bye.